Hello, this is Cristi. Let me show you how you can change camera according to the active speaker in Descript. In previous videos, you may have seen where I've assembled a sequence with multi-track with two videos, one for me, one for my guest. Let me show you how you can have Descript automatically switch camera according to who is talking. So you can see on the sidebar here, I have this composition, and on the sidebar on the left, I only have one scene throughout the entire conversation, which is about 38 minutes long. Well, I have already transcribed the files, I've already assembled the sequence, and I've already assigned speaker labels to the different people. In fact, if you look on the timeline at the bottom there, you can see that my speech is purple and my guest, which is Chris, is green. So throughout my entire project, if I zoom in close enough, you will see the different speech waveforms changing when we are talking. So this is the first requirement that you must have when you have the active speaker. You have to have the file speaker identified on each file. And the file, the audio, must be part of the video file in the sequence. So if I look in my sequence, right-click in here and say Edit Sequence, you can see the two tracks. It's me on the first track and Chris on the second track. And both our video and audio are part of the same file. That is how Descript will know which video stream to change to when a person speaks. So here, when Chris speaks, it's going to switch to his video. And when I speak in here, it's going to switch to me and back to him and so on. So let's see how this works. In my composition, I created a composition from that sequence. You can see all the waveforms, different colors at the bottom, but I don't want to create camera changes and scenes every time the speaker changes. So for this reason, Descript has a function that is very helpful to do automatic camera switch. So all you need to do is, if you click outside of the canvas here, you can see the two layers which correspond to the two tracks inside the sequence, right? So if I click one of these video layers. It doesn't matter which one. In fact, I can actually delete one of them because for this particular example, we only need one of them. So I'm going to click on my video, which is the only one in here now. And you see this section here on the sidebar called multicam? Well, at the moment in this layer that I selected, it's showing my camera, Cristi, yeah? And the fact that it says script down here, it means it's coming from the script track at the bottom. So clicking on this dropdown, it says here, active speaker. So watch this. As soon as I click that, it's going to take a couple of seconds to do it. As soon as I click that, watch the sidebar on the left with all the scenes, right? So let's do it. Click. And the interface may take a few seconds to respond, but there you go. Look at that. On the sidebar now, you see all of the different scenes with the different changing of the speaker according to where they are talking. So Descript automatically creates scenes for you to indicate that there's a new camera angle in that scene and automatically assigns that camera angle to that layer. So in fact, only one layer exists now in my scene, which is me. You know, look at this. And Chris is hidden because I deleted it. If I go to another scene right here, Chris, scene 18, that's him showing. Again, click on his layer here, and it says that the multicam shows him. If for some reason Descript got it wrong, or I changed my mind and I want to show myself in here, all I have to do is manually click on this layer, and instead of Chris, switch to Cristi. There you go. So that's how it works. So you can still do an automated active speaker at the beginning. So I recommend that you do this the first time before you add any scenes. Do that thing first. Let Descript create all the scenes for you. And then if you need to tweak them, or maybe in some scene you want to show them side by side and not just one of them, particularly if there's a quick exchange of in the conversation between them, it can be a little tiring to switch camera every few words, which means that if there is an exchange like that, I prefer to put both speakers on the screen at the same time. So if I want to do that, I can go in and grab one of the layers. Let's say that for this scene here, I want to have both of us on the screen for this scene here. I can grab my video and resize it, you know, put it like half screen like this from the side, And then I need to bring in Chris's video as well, which is now disabled, right? So you can see on the sidebar, his is grayed out, and there's this little eye icon that is closed, which means that layer is hidden. Click on that to reveal it. And of course, I want to position it on the right-hand side, scale it vertically, and pull the edge a little bit like this. And if he's not really in the center, you can still make some tweaks and, you know, put him in the center. Double click to go into crop mode. Sometimes Descript just jumps over the video. Double click and slide him to the left. Double click again to exit crop mode. And there you go. So we are now editing this particular layout. It says at the bottom here that it says I'm editing in this scene. I can also say, you know, what I'm doing now, I can apply to all scenes. I don't want to do that because it's going to change all those layouts. But look at this. This scene, number 17, shows both of us. So if I go back to scene 16 and play.
That's exactly what I did. I'm like, okay, what's this Excel thing?
That's also my attitude. Just, you know.
So there you go. The scene has changed to both of us. And here's another tip for you, and I'm done. If you want to reproduce this side-by-side layout in other places, I cover this in another video, but it's very easy. Right-click on this scene with the side-by-side view and say Copy Layout. Go somewhere else where you want to have side-by-side view, maybe here, scene number 25. Right-click, Paste Layout, and there you go. You have reproduced that layout in a couple of clicks. So this is the easiest way to do active speaker. Have the files belong to the video and audio for each person. Transcribe the files, identify speakers and assign them correctly, then put them in a sequence, add them to the composition, and then assign it to one of the layers. Doesn't matter which, set active speaker in the multicam, and it's going to do that. So I hope this was helpful. And if you like this video, please like it and subscribe to my channel. And let me have your questions in the comments. If there's any video you would like me to do, or you have any questions about Descript, feel free to reach out in the comments and I will do a video. And maybe I will see you in my Media Makers Club, where I have the Descript course and Camtasia courses, Q&A sessions, and discounted one-on-one coaching sessions with me. So hope to see you soon. Thank you and see you next time.